أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين محمد بن عبد الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي. اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا وانفعنا بما علمتنا وزدنا علما. اللهم آمين. أما بعد, we continue with the narration of the endless bounties that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestowed upon the Israelites. And last we reached to ayah number 57, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَضَلَّلْنَا عَلَيْكُمُ الْغَمَامَ وَأَنْزَلْنَا عَلَيْكُمُ الْمَنَّ وَالسَّلْوَى كُلُوا مِنْ طَيِّبَاتِ مَا رَزَقْنَاكُمْ وَمَا ظَلَمُونَا وَلَكِنْ كَانُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ يَظْلِمُونَ. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in added slew of bounties that he descended upon the Israelites, he reminds them of al-man was-salwa. Al-man was-salwa, there's a difference in opinion as to what is al-man was-salwa. But it's really sufficient for us to know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala descended al-man was-salwa upon the Israelites, and that in itself is a direct bounty that coming to a person effortlessly. In other words, there is no effort in going after, raising animals or cultivating the land or harvesting the land or any of that. Food that is blessed, that is ready, descending upon the Israelites from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds them, وَإِذْ قُلْنَا ادْخُلُوا هَذِهِ الْقَرْيَةِ. Now there is another ابتلاء here. And we said that ابتلاء or tribulation can be good or bad, depending on how a person would handle the tribulation. In other words, if a person is successful in the way they're handling the tribulation, then it certainly is good for them, that they're going to reap the benefit, they're going to reap the reward. And if they fail, then it's a tribulation, and added to that, they've lost the reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَإِذْ قُلْنَا ادْخُلُوا هَذِهِ الْقَرْيَةَ فَكُلُوا مِنْهَا حَيْثُ شِئْتُمْ رَغَدًا وَادْخُلُوا الْبَابَ سُجَّدًا وَقُولُوا حِطَّةٌ نَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ خَطَايَاكُمْ وَسَنَزِيدُ الْمُحْسِنِينَ. So yeah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling them, enter this town. And the town, according to the majority of the mufassirin, the preponderance of the evidence is Bayt al-Maqdis, is Jerusalem. And at that time it had a fence. And this is how people have secured their boundaries in the past. And they tried to protect against external attacks, is that they would have like a very, large fence with gates, doors to enter, the qariya. And in this qariya, in Bayt al-Maqdis, there were seven doors. There were seven doors. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded them now to wage what? Jihad. And it was said that part of the people of Ad were dwelling the city of Bayt al-Maqdis, or the town of Bayt al-Maqdis. And they were huge in their creation. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands the Israelites to enter. And in one ayah, where a righteous man among them say, oh my people, just enter upon them and you will become victorious. All you have to do is submit to the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Enter Bayt al-Maqdis and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will grant you victory over these people. And in one ayah, they defied the orders of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and Musa alayhi salam, and they said, idhaba, idhaba anta wa rabbuka faqatila. Go you and your Lord and fight with jihad, we're going to stay put here. This is the level of arrogance that such people have reached, to the extent that they would tell their prophets, go you and your Lord, fight, we are going to stay put, we're going to be staying put here. In this ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَقُولُوا حِطَّةً. حِطَّةً means حُطَّ عَنَّا ذُنُوبَنَا. Put down, lay down, forgive our sins. And the gate or the door that they were commanded to enter through is called بَابُ الْحِطَّةً. The door of Hitta means the door of Maghfirah, the door, the gate of forgiveness. وَقُولُوا حِطَّةٌ نَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ خَطَايَاكُمْ وَسَنَزِيدُ الْمُحْسِنِينَ. We will increase those who respond favorably to the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We're going to increase the good doors with more reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What was the outcome? فَبَدَّلَ الَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا قَوْلًا غَيْرَ الَّذِي قِيلَ لَهُمْ. Those who cause injustice to themselves, they start playing on words. So not only they're defying the orders of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not only they're defying the orders of Musa alayhi salam, their messenger, they've changed the orders in the order of the word, or the tone of the word, and they're playing on the words وقالوا حنطة. So they say instead of حطة, they said حنطة. And in one hadith that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم narrates to us, حنطة من شعيرة. Okay, playing on words, which means, roughly translated, they are making mockery of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His orders.
فبدل الذين ظلموا قولا غير الذي قيل لهم فأنزلنا على الذين ظلموا رجزا من السماء بما كانوا يفسقون.
So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as a fair and just punishment for their defiance and their arrogance, has descended upon them rijs. Rijs meaning that a punishment. And in this case was the plague. It was said that within the course of 1 hour, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala caused to destruction 70,000 of the Israelites. In 1 hour, 70,000. The plague is a punishment from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam tells us so in the hadith, that whenever you see the plague, you know, hitting a town, this is a form of punishment, it's a rijs from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continues to tell us the story of the Israelites, where this istasqa Musa liqawmi. So here they are asking in a very polite way. They say, oh Moses, we are thirsty. After, of course, they refused to enter Bayt al-Maqdis. And as a result, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has descended the plague upon them. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has written upon them that they shall be lost in the desert of Sina for 40 years. For 40 years. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala descended upon them al-man wa salwa. And then they've carried a rock that when they asked Musa alayhi salam, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives them the water to drink. When istasqa Musa liqawmi, istasqa means asking for water, asking for drinks. فَقُلْنَا اضْرِبْ بِعَصَاكَ الْحَجَرِ. So we commanded Musa alayhi salam to strike the stone or the rock with his stick. فَانْفَجَرَتْ مِنْهُ اثْنَتَا عَشْرَةَ عَيْنًا. So 12 springs, which is the number of the tribes of the Israelites, right? 12 springs has sprung up from this rock. فَانْفَجَرَتْ مِنْهُ اثْنَتَا عَشْرَةَ عَيْنًا قَدْ عَلِمَ كُلُّ أُنَاسٍ مَشْرَبُهُمْ. Every tribe exactly knows where to get the water, which spring is, you know, designated for them. قَدْ عَلِمَ كُلُّ أُنَاسٍ مَشْرَبُهُمْ كُلُوا وَاشْرَبُوا مِنْ رِزْقِ اللَّهِ كُلُوا وَاشْرَبُوا مِنْ رِزْقِ اللَّهِ وَلَا تَعْثَوْا فِي الْأَرْضِ مُفْسِدِينَ. We need to pay close attention to this ayah. Here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling them, you've supplicated to me in a dire need. And when one is thirsty, they're in need of that water more than in need of anything else. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created life, you know, by way of the water. وَجَعَلْنَا مِنَ الْمَاءِ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ حَيٍّ. And we have created from water every little thing. So here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as if He's attaching a condition to, you know, them to receive this water. He says, كُلُوا وَاشْرَبُوا. Eat from this man and salwa. وَاشْرَبُوا مِنْ رِزْقِ اللَّهِ. And drink from what that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has bestowed upon you. وَلَا تَعْثَوْا فِي الْأَرْضِ مُفْسِدِينَ. The word تَعْثَوْا, for one to cause mischief on earth, or to cause corruption, a closer translation to the word عثو. But sometimes one is causing corruption according to that which is readily apparent to us on the surface. But in reality, they're doing good. How is that? We read in Surah Al-Kahf, where Musa alayhi salam went with Al-Khidr, a righteous slave from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestowed much mercy and bounties and knowledge upon him. So Musa alayhi salam wanted to learn from him. فَانْطَلَقَ حَتَّى إِذَا رَكِبَ فِي السَّفِينَةِ فَخَرَقَهَا. When Musa alayhi salam went with Al-Khidr and they were aboard the ship, Al-Khidr struck the bottom of, you know, the ship. فَخَرَقَهَا. قَالَ أَخَرَقْتَهَا لِتُغْرِقَ أَهْلَهَا. So Musa now, without the knowledge that the Khidr has, he's judging by what's on the surface. قَالَ أَخَرَقْتَهَا لِتُغْرِقَ أَهْلَهَا. لَقَدْ جِئْتَ شَيْئًا إِمْرًا. You really brought something that is against the Sharia. This is an act of corruption. So Al-Khidr said, قَالَ أَلَمْ أَقُلْ إِنَّكَ لَمْ تَسْتَطِيعَ مَعَيَ صَبْرًا. He said, did I tell you will not be patient with me? قَالَ لَا تُؤَخِذْنِي بِمَا نَسِيتُ وَلَا تُرْهِقْنِي مِنْ أَمْرِي عُسْرًا. He said, pardon me, I have forgotten, and don't be hard on me. And this is really a quality of a teacher with a student, that they should not be hard on their students. فَانْطَلَقَ حَتَّى إِذَا أَتَى أَهْلَ قَرَيَةٍ اسْتَطَعْنَا أَهْلَهَا فَأَبَوْا أَيُّ ضَيِّفُهُمَا. They went until they reached a town
where its people were just so miserly stingy. To the extent that one is asking you for food, and no one asks for food unless they're really hungry. And this is like, according to some of the Mufassirin, is a right for one, you know, the wayfarer, that if he comes to your house or to your town, and they're asking for food and water, that you would give them the hospitality of at least 3 days. فَأَبَوْا أَن يُضَيِّفُوهُمَا فَوَجَدَ فِيهَا جِدَارًا يُرِيدُ أَن يَنْقَضَّ فَأَقَامَ. So he saw that there is a fence about to collapse. So now he's rectifying the fence. Right? He's rectifying the fence. So he's doing something good. But subhanAllah, he rectified that fence to the extent that it's a temporary fence, meaning that it's going to collapse in a few more years. When? When these young orphans reach the age of maturity. And based upon what? Upon knowledge from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then, you know, they go for another trip, and now they see a young boy. فانطلق حتى إذا لقي غلاما فقتله. Now you see a young boy and somebody kills this person in front of you. It's like this is an innocent child. Again, Musa alayhi salam judges by what's on the surface, that you are causing corruption on earth. قال أقتلت نفسا زكية بغير نفس. You have killed a righteous soul, a pure soul, without just cause. بغير نفس, the just cause is that this boy is innocent. He didn't kill another soul for you to kill him. قال هذا فراق بيني وبينك. The point here is that al-'uthu sometimes is causing corruption for the sake of what? For the sake of doing something good. So the hole in the ship is to prevent the unjust ruler from taking the ship. And so we are permitted, you know, from a Sharia perspective, to cause small harm in order to achieve the greater good. You go to a physician, and then sometimes he's like saying, okay, I gotta remove this part from your body. Well, that's corruption. Yeah, but it's a small corruption in comparison to the overall benefit that the patient is going to receive. Right? Okay? So, al-'uthu fil ard, it does not mean that is corrupt, absolute corruption. Because here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَا تَعْثَوْ فِي الْأَرْضِ مُفْسِدِينَ. In other words, the intention is what? Is that you are causing corruption for no greater good. There's no benefit that's going to be materialized. So here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as if He's putting the pressure on them, is that as you're asking me for food and water, and I'm giving you that, I'm reminding you to be grateful for these bounties. كُلُوا وَاشْرَبُوا مِنْ رِزْقِ اللَّهِ. And this risk is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is not by way of what you earned. Right? And later in the ayat, they commit kufr. Just like the people of Aad, who lived in Al-Yemen. لَقَدْ كَانَ لِسَبَئٍ فِي مَسْكَنِهِمْ آيَةٍ. Sabah, the people of Aden and Yemen, when they were able to erect a dam and stop the the water and reap the benefit from the water, right? They disbelieved in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They said, we are mighty people. We can do anything. We can put this earth to our use, so on and so forth. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us about the two paradises or oases that they've had, right? And He replaced that with what? With other two barely, fruit or vegetation produced in oasis that is actually distasteful, but it only sustains the life of a human being. So that's why the scholars tell us, بِالشُّكْرِ تَدُومُ النِّعَمُ. If one is materializing a bounty or a group of bounties from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they endeavor in giving shukr and gratitude by way of their actions to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it's more likely that this bounty not only will last, but will also grow and prosper. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us among those who render the due gratitude to Him, inshaAllah. وَإِذْ قُلْتُمْ يَا مُوسَى لَنْ نَصْبِرَ عَلَىٰ طَعَامٍ وَاحِدٍ. So, and when you said, O Moses, we shall not be patient by way of receiving just one type of food. And one type of food does not mean just one item that they were receiving. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells about al-man was-salwa. So there's more than one type, but more than one kind of food, but it's within with the same category. وَإِذْ قُلْتُمْ يَا مُوسَى لَنْ نَصْبِرَ عَلَىٰ طَعَامٍ وَاحِدٍ فَادْعُ لَنَا رَبَّكَ يُخْرِجْ لَنَا مِمَّا تُنْبِتُ الْأَرْضُ مِنْ بَقْلِهَا وَقِثَّائِهَا وَفُومِهَا وَعَدَسِهَا وَبَصَلِهَا. So they're asking for all this stuff that comes out of the earth, that you have to cultivate, and then you have to wait for it to come out, and then you have to harvest, and then you have to cook. So the immediate answer came, أَتَسْتَبْدِلُونَ الَّذِي هُوَ أَدْنَى بِالَّذِي هُوَ خَيْرٌ. Yani, how foolish can be a person that when they have something that is so great from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and then they ask for something that is of a lesser quality. Something, a direct bounty that's coming to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to you effortlessly. You put that aside and then you ask for something that is coming from earth. You're asking for onions, and you're asking for grains, and you're asking for this and that. قَالَ تَسْتَبْدِلُونَ الَّذِي هُوَ أَدْنَى بِالَّذِي هُوَ خَيْرٌ اهْبِطُوا مِصْرًا فَإِنَّ لَكُمْ مَا سَأَلْتُمْ. Go to Egypt, that's according to many of the interpretations. فَإِنَّ لَكُمْ مَا سَأَلْتُمْ. Indeed, you shall have there that which you've asked for. فَضُرِبَتْ عَلَيْهِمُ الذِّلَّةُ وَالْمَسْكَنَةُ وَضُرِبَتْ عَلَيْهِمُ الذِّلَّةُ وَالْمَسْكَنَةُ وَبَاءُوا بِغَضَبٍ مِنَ اللَّهِ. ذِلَّة means humiliation as a result of their request to replace that which is of a greater good to that which is of lesser good, or that which is of greater quality with that which is of lesser quality. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, go to Egypt, indeed you shall be humiliated there as an equal and a just recompense for their request. وَضُرِبَتْ عَلَيْهِمُ الذِّلَّةُ وَالْمَسْكَنَةُ وَبَاءُوا بِغَضَبٍ مِّنَ اللَّهِ. وَبَاءُوا means is the very word ba'a means that the punishment, the anger from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the wrath from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is equivalent to that which they've committed in terms of crimes. And to that which is equivalent. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the all just. Whether he's going to punish them in this dunya and the hereafter, it's equivalent to that. وَبَاءُوا بِغَضَبٍ مِّنَ اللَّهِ ذَلِكَ بِأَنَّهُمْ كَانُوا يَكْفُرُونَ بِآيَاتِ اللَّهِ وَيَقْتُلُونَ النَّبِيِّينَ بِغَيْرِ الْحَقِّ ذَلِكَ بِمَا عَصَوْا وَكَانُوا يَعْتَدُونَ. So what is the crime that they've committed? That they've disbelieved in the ayat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. ذَلِكَ مِنَّهُمْ كَانُوا يَكْفُرُونَ بِآيَاتِ اللَّهِ وَيَقْتُلُونَ النَّبِيِّينَ بِغَيْرِ الْحَقِّ. And they would kill the prophets and the messengers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala without just cause. Killing a prophet or a messenger or a righteous person by a disbeliever, because the disbeliever or the corrupt feel that this symbol of righteousness, this role model, this sunnah of this person is a direct threat to them. Is a direct threat to them. So to eliminate that threat and to not have something to remind them of the evil that they're committing, because it is the human nature to measure ourselves to others. You know, if you're measuring yourself to somebody who's better, you'll say, well, maybe he prays better than I do, or more than I do. Maybe he fasts more days than I do. But if one is not a righteous person, they usually want to compare themselves to who? To those who are worse than them. So now that they see the prophets and the messengers as a beautiful role model for humanity, for that, for righteousness, for piety, for taqwa, they want to eliminate them. ذَلِكَ بِأَنَّهُمْ كَانُوا يَكْفُرُونَ بِآيَاتِ اللَّهِ وَيَقْتُلُونَ النَّبِيِّينَ بِغَيْرِ الْحَقِّ ذَلِكَ بِمَا عَصَوْا وَكَانُوا يَعْتَدُونَ. This is their just recompense because of their disobedience and their transgression over the orders and the ayat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us among those الذين يستمعون القول فيتبعون أحسنه. Those who listen to the best, to the words of wisdom, and they follow the best of it. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala الرضاء بعد القضاء. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us pleased with whatever decree He decrees for us. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to cause us to live so long that we live as Muslims, and to die in a state of iman. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive our sins and our shortcomings. والآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته.